So this video is an introduction to a whole series of titration problems in which we've got a weak acid reacting with a strong base. I'm going to write the reaction up here. The acid has how many carbons? It says there, four. CH3, CH2, CH2, and then the COOH, which is the acid, and that's the organic acid group that gives it away that it's an acid, plus it gives me a Ka value for it that lets me know it's a weak acid. And that is reacting with sodium hydroxide, and the sodium is just a spectator ion, so I'm only going to write the OH minus. Now these are in aqueous solution. That strong base right there will force this reaction to completion. So the products for this reaction will be this donating its proton to the water and leaving me with the products. Now, that ends up being a very lengthy way to write a reaction. So to get it all on one line, I'm just going to let this represent the weak acid. It has a donatable proton. It is reacting with the strong base. It is a one-way reaction because of that strong base. The acid donates to the base, giving me A minus plus water. So for each one of these calculations, we'll be considering this reaction first because this is the titration reaction. What I want to do in this introduction video is kind of talk our way through each one of these points. You see that we have part A through part H to consider here. So let us go over to the screen and walk our way through what's happening. So these are the amounts of the base that you're adding. A is where you haven't added any base, and its initial concentration, its the initial pH is determined only by the concentration of that weak acid. So this is merely a weak acid problem. Okay, so I'll just say weak acid here, and that's all that we have. Then we start adding some of the base. When we add 10 milliliters of base, we get to this point right here. And when we add 15 milliliters, we're at this point here. And then 19 is getting close to the equivalence point. In this region right here, what we will have is have converted some of our weak acid to its conjugate base. And we will have a buffer during this region. As we get close to the equivalence point, which I've established that this is the equivalence point, when we get close to that equivalence point, it starts to rise rapidly, but then when we get right here where we have equal mole amounts of both acid and base, we're at the equivalence point. Now notice that would happen right here, okay? Whoops. I don't know what I do to touch buttons here, but let's get back to that. All right, so right here at 20 milliliters, since the molarity of the base and the molarity of the acid are exactly the same, you're going to reach the equivalence point when the volumes of the acid and the volume of the base are exactly the same. So we're at the 20 milliliter mark here for the equivalence point. Equivalence point is when you have just converted all of the weak acid, which is this guy, over to its conjugate base. Then what you do is you keep on adding, and when you keep on adding extra base, you'll notice that the pH will shoot up rapidly beyond that equivalence point, and then just steadily and slowly climb as you keep on adding a little bit more base and a little bit more base. pH is a base 10 scale, so it doesn't climb really rapidly like you think it might as you go, but because of that base log base 10, it is a slow climb as you go forward from there. So that is the reaction that we're going to consider, and I'm going to do a whole series of videos where you can watch me do the calculations so you can pick and choose. Maybe you know how to do the pH of a weak acid and you can skip A, but you'll want to see how to do maybe something in the buffer range or the equivalence point. So we're going to work through these one at a time.